we're hoping to get Mark Emery on the phone because he promised he'd phone us from jail, which is where he's biding his time these days, waiting for extradition down to the U.S. on charges of importing marijuana into the United States. He's a controversial figure. He calls himself the Prince of Pot. What's prison like for him? What's his future going to hold for him? And I think we've got him on the line now. Do we have him? Carly, have we got Mark Emery? Okay, let's see if we can get him on. Oh, we're just going to need to take a second. There he is. Mark, hi.
Hello.
Nice to have you.
Oh, hey, Christy. How are you?
Fine, thank you. We got you right on right away here.
Oh, good.
I'm imagining you're probably getting calls out from prison. Isn't that easy?
It isn't that easy, no. And they charge you 90 cents, too, for only 15 minutes.
Oh, well. Well, hopefully, Mark, you've got enough money to cover that, right?
I do. I got $64 on my card, so I'm good to go for another 70 calls.
Now, what's it like there, Mark? Describe for us what your surroundings look like now.
Well, I'm locked into an 8-foot by 10-foot concrete and steel cell for 18 to 20 hours of the day. And for the 4 to 6 hours I'm not in that cell, I'm in an open range where you get food and you go shower and you can walk in this little 20-foot by 10-foot area that has sunlight coming through it. And a day like today, that's kind of good because it's rained for 3 days. And it's an incredibly boring routine, really. But slowly but surely, newspapers are arriving. And I got a letter from Jody today.
Your wife?
Yes. And there's a television in our room, so I saw the Canucks play poorly last night. But otherwise, I'm writing extensively. I wrote up a lot of material already and sent it to Jody for putting on our blogs and what have you. And I can talk to my staff still by calling them and finding out what's going on. I can call only in those 4 to 6 hours I'm let out of my cell because the phones are out in the range area.
So you can run your business from jail?
Well, actually, the business has been transferred legally over to my wife, so she's the director. But I can advise them and help them out and everything like that. But I'm not really in a position to do much more than just hear how they're doing. And I typically talk about how the campaign to free Mark is going more than the actual business because I've left competent people in charge, and Jody's had to be taught how to run the business and things like that. She's got kind of an onerous job now. She's doing my job, her job, and answering a lot of questions about what's happening to me and what's going to happen to me and what have you. But I'm making the best of it. I'm still mentally fit, and I'm still cheerful, and the inmates are very polite to me, and they always are typically in prisons, and
now,
so I'm
now,
coping.
Now, so Mark, you are advising on how to run your marijuana-based business from prison while you're in jail because you've been charged with importing marijuana or exporting marijuana to the United States.
Well, marijuana seeds, of course, and we don't sell those. We haven't sold those for 4 years. We don't actually sell anything that's illegal, and nothing in our business conducts is at all questionable right now. I would contest that even seeds aren't that very questionable, since my block that my store is in has 5 seed stores that have been selling for years and years on my block alone, and there's over 10 in Vancouver and over 100 in Canada selling the exact same things I did to Americans, to anybody.
But not all of them sending them by mail, by post into the U.S.
Oh, they all do. Don't be fooled.
But you think they've singled you out?
Oh, well, I'm certain of it. Have you ever heard of anybody else being charged for seeds ever in your life? There's not a single person in America that was ever charged for selling seeds, let alone Canada.
No, they want to make an example of you. I mean, Mark, it's not like you've avoided publicity. It's not like you've avoided trying to be a spokesperson for this. Didn't it seem to you, perfectly obvious that you might be made a target of?
Of course, it's my intention to be made a target. I wanted to attract the attention because I don't want anyone else to represent our movement, because I don't believe others have the correct philosophical background to represent the movement. You know, I come from a very pure position. I never kept any of this money. I gave $4 million away from 1994 to 2005. Every cent we ever earned was given away. I didn't keep any of this money. I've never lived. I don't have property, bonds, apartments, furniture, stocks, anything. I've never owned any property whatsoever in my entire 15 years in Vancouver. I paid all my taxes on it. I'm not charged with any type of tax avoidance or tax evasion or illegal filing or anything. And certainly have the only charge I've even had in Canada in the last 10 years was passing a joint in Saskatoon in 2004. And of course, that got me into trouble with the city licensing department. And one of the good things about Jody now running the business and officially being a director of it is that they'll have no trouble getting a business license, because all 6 concerns that City Hall had were all based on the Mark Emery factor and his passing this joint in Saskatoon. So the establishment has been highly prejudicial towards me, but they're picking on the wrong person. Because I like to think that I've been doing this for 30 years in Canada, and I'm well known. Everybody in Canada has grown up with me, as it were, and they know my intentions are sincere and legitimate. So I have every confidence most of the public understands this correctly.
So you are complaining about being in prison, but you wanted to be in prison. You want to be made an example of.
Well, it's like that scene where Darth Vader finally kills Obi-Wan Kenobi, and Obi-Wan says, "You're going to make me more powerful than you can possibly imagine." And when you look at every major freedom fighter around the world, from Václav Havel, the president currently of Czechoslovakia, or Czech Republic, and Nelson Mandela, and Gandhi, all the people I admire, Martin Luther King, they had to go to jail. They had to go to jail to draw attention to it, because injustice is something that can fan the flames of radicalism. And that's what I need. I need thousands and thousands of little Mark Emerys in teenagers, young women, young men, older men, women, becoming like me. And the only way to do that is to inflame their passion by being a martyr. And I've seen historically how this can work to someone's advantage over time. So what happens to me is not so important as what happens to our movement as a result of what happens to me.
It is a stretch, Mark Emery, to compare yourself to Nelson Mandela, Václav Havel, Martin Luther King, to call yourself a martyr when you've made millions doing this.
Yes,
you love to talk to the media. You're a self-aggrandizer of the worst kind of sort. You're up for political office. I mean, you are not the same as Martin Luther King, for heaven's sakes.
I beg to differ. Martin Luther King defended a people who were prejudicially and discriminated against, and yet no one's put in jail because they're black. People are put in jail all over the world every hour of every day for embracing a plant that God put on this earth, and we're a harmless, peaceful, pacifistic people, just like Martin Luther King represented, just like Gandhi represented, just like Mandela's group was at ANC. They were a terrorist organization. They used violence. I have never advocated violence, nor would I ever use it. Everything I've done is peaceful. I gave away every cent I ever made, and I'm really offended. You would say I was greedy and I made lots of money.
Well, you said you made $4 million at least, right?
Christy,
that's just the money you gave away.
I gave away more money than you'll make in a lifetime. So I think that that shows that I'm completely sincere and that I was always pacifistic, and I represented people who are obviously discriminated against. There's thousands of Canadians in jail right now for marijuana, and in the United States there's 70,000 people in jail for marijuana. Not a single one of them should be spending a minute in jail based on their love of a plant or their cultivation of a plant.
Mark, surely the difference between you
and aggrandizement, Christy, come on, you're a politician.
But I don't claim to be pure. I mean, I don't claim to have the purest principles like you do, Mark.
Well,
and it seems to me like the difference between you and Martin Luther King is that among other things is that Martin Luther King was defending people who were being discriminated against for who they are. You are defending people who you believe are being discriminated for what they choose to do.
Well, what society says
is not acceptable. I mean, it's not. This is a totally different kind of case.
It is not, and you're so incorrect. I represent a people who are oppressed, who have done nothing to harm anyone, just like blacks or South Africans. I would point out the
ANC. But they choose to break the law. It's not like they're born black and therefore are discriminated against in a society that favors whites.
What if we outlawed Christianity or Islam or vegetarianism or Falun Gong? These are all choices people make. What if Jewish people, because you can choose your religion, it's not a race to be Jewish, and yet people in the 1930s were discriminated against because of their choice of religion. It happens everywhere all the time, except it never happens in greater numbers than the number of marijuana people put in jail. 250,000 people put in jail for a peaceful lifestyle choice they make. I'm offended with you, Christy Clark, for even implying that our struggle is any less legitimate than their struggles. It's insulting.
Mark Emery, we're out of time with you. Thank you for joining us in jail.
The vigil that starts tomorrow.
Vigil starts tomorrow.
That's right. And it's going to be everywhere.
What time?
It starts tomorrow in the afternoon. It'll be here every day, just like it was when I was at Saskatoon Correctional. There was a big tent city across from the courthouse for 56 days. Every day I was in jail in Saskatoon 5 years ago, and this is just the
beginning.
And
you're at POCO pretrial, right?
I'm at North Fraser.
North Fraser pretrial. In Port Coquitlam, right?
Yes.
All right. People know where to find you.
Yeah,
thanks.
They do.
Thank you, Mark.
Bye.
Mark Emery, the self-proclaimed Prince of Pot, phoning us today from prison. Now I'm going to open up the lines to you. He says that he is the next Martin Luther. Well, I want to be fair to him. He compares himself to Martin Luther King. He disputes me when I say that the causes are different. He says that their cause in freeing people to be able to smoke pot and use marijuana is no less a noble cause than the fight to free blacks from discrimination in the United States. How does that make you feel?